What's up, everybody? It's the Smooth Terrorist. That's right. The Smooth Terrorist. I'm back. Now, as some of you probably already know, I'm not really a new face here on YouTube. I used to go by the name of Fake Sagan, and I was banned ostensibly for bullying a grown man, and then later re-uploading that video again after my ban was rescinded, and I came back and yada yada yada. A whole bunch of shit happened. If you missed it, I'm sorry. Do you like my new intro? It was made by a gentleman named Metal Org, so give it up for Metal Org. And the little piece of music on there was composed by Ocean Divine. Actually, it was composed by Michael Jackson and then ripped off by Ocean Divine. Anyway, I've got a lot to talk about and only 15 motherfucking minutes to do it in. So I will be brief. Some of you may be wondering, why am I back now? Why didn't I come back 6 months or a year ago? Why am I not coming back 6 months from now? Why now? What's so special about now? Nothing. I just did it, okay? You know, I've been waffling back and forth with the idea of returning to YouTube ever since I was banned, and I'm torn between my love for having a soapbox and talking about my ideas on the internet, and my extreme hatred for Google and their corporate censorship, which kind of relegates us all to the level of children. And, you know, I guess adults aren't allowed to disagree with each other around here anymore. We all have to be family friendly. So yeah, I've been going back and forth for a while with the idea of coming back, and I just finally decided to do it. There's no rhyme or reason. It happened now because it happened. You know, if anybody wonders about the circumstances that I left under, you know, I'm aware there's a percentage out there who believe that I got myself banned deliberately, and, you know, it's no secret I was talking about leaving YouTube for a while before they banned me because I was unhappy with Google. You know, I joined YouTube in 2006 when it was just YouTube, and when Google took over, everything started to suck. But I don't need to tell you guys that, all right? You all know, because it's gotten worse since they banned me. I've been keeping track of some of the developments. Anyway, you know, I'll put it to you like this. If you're the kind of person that's bound and determined to believe that I got myself banned on purpose, and you think that rape victims dress too provocatively and it's their own fault, or that when the cops murder somebody, it's like suicide by cop. You know, I don't know what to tell you. If you believe that, fine. I think it speaks volumes that I was banned and didn't leave voluntarily, but what are you going to do? You know, people are going to believe what they believe. Anyway, but I'm back now, and I'm not going anywhere unless Google forces me off. So, now that I'm back, I'm really back. I missed you too. I missed you guys too. Yeah, I heard it's gotten a little bit boring without me. Well, those days are over. Now, I spent a lot of time thinking about what I would do if I ever came back to YouTube. And I think that, you know, since I have to start from square one again and kind of build my viewership back up, there's nothing better than a good publicity stunt for that. And no one does them like I do, right? So, Mr. Straight Dope, if that is indeed your real name. It's funny because it's not. I challenge you, sir, to a debate. Now, some of you may remember that Straight Dope made a video about me way back in the day called Fake Sagan Fails, and I didn't respond to it. I didn't have anything to say. And I know there were a lot of people saying, well, what is that? Is he a coward? You know, Fake Sagan's not the type to back down from a fight. Well, the fact is, I wasn't a coward. Straight Dope was. You know, how do you fight a shadow? How do you kill that which is already dead? There's really no way to respond to a video by a guy that well, you know, a person, assuming that he's even a guy, that we really know nothing about. I mean, you know, look at the position that Straight Dope was in when he made this video about me, right? He knows what I look like, he knows where I live, he knows what I do for a living, he knows who my friends are, he knows who I'm dating, he knows my political beliefs, my religious beliefs, my hopes, my dreams, my aspirations, yada, yada, yada. He's just got this wealth of information about me, and what do I know about Straight Dope? He has a computer. He might be male. He probably lives in Canada because he's got that accent. Yeah, you know, but that's the point. That's what I want to debate you about, Straight Dope. I think you're a pussy. I think this was further illustrated when you made Fake Sagan Fails Volume 2 right after I got banned, knowing full well that I wouldn't be able to respond to it even if I wanted to. And, you know, you realized that once I was gone, there were going to be 10,000 people going, "Where's Fake Sagan? What happened to him?" And if you used my name in any way, then they would all kind of cling to you like rats clinging to a piece of wreckage from my sunken ship. So you capitalized off my demise, and now I'm back, you know. And you're part of the reason why. You know, like I said, I've kind of been going back and forth on whether or not to return to YouTube. But I was in Blog TV earlier tonight, and I ran across Mr. Straight Dope. Now, a lot of people know that I've been toying around with the idea of returning to YouTube and challenging Straight Dope to a debate. So, not surprisingly, people started egging us on and saying, "Come on, guys, you're going to fight. Come on, Fake Sagan, let's do this debate thing. Come on, Straight Dope." And, you know, I just assumed that a guy who made two videos about me, you know, when this opportunity presented itself, he would just be like, "Yeah, Fake Sagan, let's fucking do this, punk." But instead, he really kind of hedged at the idea. He was like, "Whoa, you know, I didn't agree to any kind of debate." And that just filled me with so much loathing and contempt at what a coward you are, Straight Dope. You really pick and choose your fights, don't you? Yeah, you debated Brett Keane. Congratulations, toppling that monumental competitor right there. You really slew a fucking giant with that one. And you know, I've noticed that there's a pattern to the people that you make videos about. You know, you made a video about Mannix the Pirate, and Mannix is a great guy. I'm a Mannix fan, but we all know he doesn't really do the pwnage thing. He doesn't make those type of videos. That's his choice, you know, whatever floats his boat. But you've also made it clear that you, you know, that you don't like my friend the Amazing Atheist, and yet you've never directly challenged him. And I think that's because you know he would step up to the challenge. You know, well, stepping up isn't something that I would have done before you debated Brett Keane. Because, you know, if I make a pwnage video about you, what am I gonna say? You know, that's some sloppy editing work. You know, poor choice of Google image clip art between the... Nobody knows anything about you, and that's the point. You've got this Harry Potter-like cloak of invisibility that you hide behind because you're a scared little dude. But you slipped up when you debated Brett Keane. You really fucked up there, Dopey, and I gotta assume that you didn't think I would ever come back to YouTube, or else you wouldn't have done that. Well, I am back, and now you have no excuse not to debate me. You can't say I'm not important enough. You've made videos about me. You can't say you don't do debates because you debated Brett. Now, I know you're a guy who doesn't like a level playing field. That much is apparent to any idiot around here. You know, you like a stacked deck. You like the odds to be tilted in your favor. So I'm going to make some stipulations right now, and they're non-negotiable, okay? There's not going to be any impartial third-party moderator, because let's get real. There's no such thing as an impartial third party. Everybody has an opinion, and I'm not going to have someone refereeing this match. We're not going to use Robert's Rules of Order. There's not going to be time limits. There's not going to be a point system. This is just going to be a battle of rhetoric. You know, ancient Greek forum style. Just two orators going head-to-head in a knockdown, drag-out brawl for it all. You pussied out on Blog TV when people brought this up, but I don't think you're going to back down now that it's on YouTube. And, I can tell you right now this isn't going to happen this week. I've got the week from hell in front of me. I'm moving down from the North Shore of Louisiana to a new apartment in New Orleans. I've got to be all week in Fox Studios shooting this reality show thing that I'm doing, which I'd love to talk more about, but 15-minute time limit. But we will do this, and I think it's good that it'll take a while, because that gives us time to build some hype. Now, if you accept my challenge, don't do some sneaky, underhanded shit like telling everybody that you emailed me and, oh, I never responded to you, and, oh, I guess he doesn't really want to do it. No, don't do anything pussy like that. If you accept my challenge, make a video. Signal your intent to do this. There will be no backing down after that for either one of us. I hope you say yes, Dopey. I think you're a coward. I don't think anybody should respect what you do. I think the only reason that some people do is that they're mostly anonymous users themselves, and they want to believe that this cowardly little nothing who hides in his mom's basement and doesn't show his face can be a tough guy. I think they want to believe that so hard, and I'm going to smash that dream. Okay, because I'm not Brett Keane, Dopey. You know, you haven't tangled with the likes of me. You don't want to. You really don't want to. So, I'm back, everybody. This has been the Smooth Terrorist, and if you enjoyed this video and you don't want to see it go the way of the dinosaur, then download it, re-upload it, parody it, make it your own, because the folks at Google can't censor me unless you let them.